Hi everyone, it's day 2 of Dark Visions number 9 on the global server, and we'll start off with the magical domain of ice and water. Now if I sound tired to you, that has a reason. I literally woke up 10 minutes ago, had barely enough time to brush my teeth, and the only thing I do want to do right now is go to bed to sleep. But I will power through this, just for you. Okay, I'm choosing a fire team again. I will just pretty much rinse and repeat the same strategy I did the day before yesterday, with very small changes. So Elina and Mastermind Zorn are wearing non-elemental weapons, as you can see. That is the only real change here. Oh, and by the way, I did not forget to equip Elina with a Trustmaster, Super Trustmaster this time around, so she can actually triple cast now. Yoshikiri is going to be the one who imbues everyone with ice and buffs Terra's Limit Burst by 150. Oh, I forgot to equip her with Call of the Wild. That is very important here. Call of the Wild. And let's unequip some stuff here. I'm super confused why there is no... What is missing? Oh, I see what's missing. Okay. Let's try this without Sora's Limit Burst ability. And if it overcaps again, I just have to take off more gear. So Vaan. Breaking, Imperil, Realm, LB Gauge Fill, and that's it pretty much. Okay, not gonna make a cut because this is very straightforward. And let's hope for no preemptive strike, because that would ruin the whole strategy. Nobody has any resistances whatsoever. Perfect, there is no preemptive. So Yoshikiri shifts. I believe it's two-hit combo. Ice Scroll. And Ninjutsu Kaihu. Vaan. Limits. Realm. Double sketch. You're still standing with your post-war portrait. That fits LB gauge for Terra. Terra caps. Let's imbue everyone. Vaan limits. Let's hope Vaan doesn't kill, but he shouldn't. This is a magical stage after all. Excellent. Although he did 3%. Elina. Regular Elina will Blade of the Dawn 3 times. And Zorn is going to Obscure Solitude 3 times. And we can pretty much go right away. So Terra starts and the AR chainers follow up. Terra did overflow yet again, so let's take off some high items. I hate this so much. Why is she this strong? Let's take off Duty to the World then, I guess. How much limit burst damage do I have now? 130. Okay. This should be fine now. The bosses are technically stronger than on Thursday as well, so I'm surprised. Okay, let's just reload. Let's have her go first, let's have Vaan follow up. Okay, and let's do it again. That was still overloaded or overflowed. Let's do this once more and take off some more gear. What did I take off last time? I believe it was Eris Glove. Now let's take off that one as well and do this again. Okay. But now we should be good. Ren does this. Yoshi Ice Crawl. One limit. Terra starts. A day follow up. I didn't see any damage from Terra, funnily enough. Because she didn't do any damage. Is she really that strong? I can't believe what I'm seeing, to be honest. Let's take off this as well. That didn't even happen on Monday, to be honest. Oops, he doesn't have any Brave Shift. Okay. Yoshi. Barn. Terra. There we go. She finally killed the boss and overcapped heavily. So even if it was 4 casts from Elena and Zaun, this is enough because you need 6 total attacks with the correct element. Varn did one and Terra did one, basically. Okay, let's do the same thing for the final boss. Oh, and I'm switching these two around here. Let's hope there's no preemptive strike on this one as well, and we'll be good. There is none. Perfect. Let's shift Yoshi. Let's shift Terra. And let's just reload all of this. Yoshi first. Bart next. Terra. Goes in, they follow up, and we are done. There we go. That was an easy, quick cap. And that's it for that stage. Now, I might do videos after Monday where I do this without Terra or Ibarra, but I believe the strat is very straightforward. Okay, see you in a moment for the physical domain of Wind and Darkness.